One of the things that we tried to do in our work is to move beyond simply looking at computer security in terms of the technical details of, say, a vulnerability or an attack, and instead focus on what is the ecosystem that makes the attackers want to do this. I'm Stefan Savage. I'm a professor of computer science and engineering at the University of California, San Diego. I look at cybersecurity using computer science and social science. One of the areas we did a bunch of work was focused on email spam, which is unwanted email that is sent to people, primarily driven by economic motive. They're trying to sell you, whether it's typically it's counterfeit products, Viagra, luxury goods, and so forth. Instead of focusing on how do we block the emails, we focused on how do we block the profitability? How do we keep them from making money sending spam? So as we measured all of this spam, what we found ourselves interested in is where are the choke points in the business model? Through the work, we were able to identify that the choke point was at the banks. And in fact, there were a very small number of banks that actually monetized all of the spam that was going on. We then worked with brand holders and the credit card companies and a number of other regulators to set up a system where they could track the flow of money and identify those bank accounts and shut them down. It's important to care about computer security to the extent that we depend on computing in every facet of our lives. And the consequence is that we actually have computing controlling parts of our lives that we aren't aware are being controlled, and that creates new risks and new challenges. We had become interested in the extent to which automobiles had become computerized, and that with features like what are called telematics, OnStar, Safety Connect, InSync, and so forth, that they would reach back and talk to the internet. We knew nothing about automobiles. We knew a fair amount about computer security. So we just bought some cars and set the students loose and said, see if you can hack these cars. And the end result was that we were able to basically take over the cars completely. Pretty much anything that your car can do, we could do remotely. So as we discovered that there were quite a few vulnerabilities in vehicles, all of the automotive companies, to varying extent, now take the cybersecurity threat seriously. We've also started to look at other parts of transportation. And so we've been going through a similar procedure we did for automobiles, for aircraft, trying to understand what potential vulnerabilities there are and how would we change it going forward. Who I want to reach are the people who run companies and regulators and the population at large who ultimately has to make computer security decisions. And influencing the research community is great, but my goal ultimately is to make all of us more secure. It's very exciting to get to work on something that is both intellectually stimulating and at the same time creates an opportunity to make the world a better place for people and for them to be safer online. I never expected to win a MacArthur Fellowship, and the fellowship will allow me to reach the people that I need to reach with my research results and my message that I couldn't reach before.